What is KOSU? KOSU comes from the Japanese and means number of labor hours per unit of output. KOSU is the labor productivity indicator of a given manufacturing cell and takes into consideration the quantity of unit of production produced in a given production time and the number of employees used for this purpose. The unit of productivity used in KOSU is usually a man, second, and is continuously visualized. KOSU indicates what the actual labor productivity of a given workstation, manufacturing cell, or production line is. Do you know why it is relative to actual productivity? It stems from the fact that it is based on actual efficiency, for example, the actual quantity of production output in a certain unit of time, usually expressed in an hour. The production time used to calculate KOSU is net time less certain standard production events at the time the production is not performed. These events are related to the organization of the plant's production and results from the regulations and labor laws. The following activities will therefore be deduced: breaks, breakfast, lunch, changeovers, cleaning and tidying up, organizational meetings, TPM standards and activities, and so on and so forth. Of course, the amount of time and type of such breaks must be previously agreed upon. KOSU is a productivity management presented in a visual form. The most commonly used form is the productivity chart, where, as we have already discussed, the unit of time is the clock hour. This allows a fairly accurate monitoring of the productivity and gives the opportunity to increase the response rate if this indicator decreases. KOSU is considered to be more authentic than other productivity or efficiency indicators. Are you wondering why? Owing to the fact that KOSU gives a better idea of the labor costs, after all, the man second or man hour is a well understood unit in this aspect. In addition, this indicator enables a better understanding of the correlation between performance output and the losses that reduce it. Therefore, it strongly highlights wastes, muda. Employees can better understand the objectives to be achieved in KOSU, because as for any indicator, such an objective must be defined. This is all related to the removal of the problems and anomalies rather than manufacturing greater quantity of goods over time. We now know what KOSU is, so we can move on to discuss the subsequent issue, which is calculation of the KOSU indicator. What do we need to calculate KOSU? Available time, agreed break times, number of employees in a workstation, quantity of products made in the time available. The formula for the KOSU calculation is as follows. Let's therefore make an exemplary KOSU calculation. This will be a reference period with a morning break that is 30 minutes for employees. The workstation is not in operation during the break. The workstation is usually operated by 3 employees. During this period, 60 pieces of finished goods were made. This gives us 3,600 seconds of time available in a clock hour, where the break is 1,800 seconds. By substituting all the numbers into the formula, we obtain an actual KOSU result of 90 man seconds unit in the reference period under consideration. It is also worth noting that in the example shown, all the items produced were of good quality. Otherwise, we should enter only good products, resulting in an increase in the KOSU indicator. We should show the quality losses. As we can see, it is easy to calculate KOSU in terms of an hour, but is that all? Of course not. KOSU is, after all, an indicator, so it must have a target, which is called the KOSU target. We will have to set this target. There is also an additional parameter in the KOSU standard. It is called the optimal target, and it results from the fact that we aim not at the KOSU target itself, but at the area between it and a value that is without waste, but which is achievable by the workstation, manufacturing cell, or production line. This can be seen in the chart. The blue line indicates the KOSU target, and the purple line the optimal target. Now we will soon become familiar with the methodology, but firstly, let's answer the following question. How to set targets? We will start with a measurement methodology. The measurement is made from a given workstation manufacturing cell or production line, and for a given product, which is in a way consistent with a method of determining the standard cycle time for a product using the time study method. Remember that the following conditions are necessary. Actual measurements are able to be made. Video recordings or measurements are to be undertaken by means of a timer on the production line. Quantity of samples, at least 20 for cycle times up to 5 minutes. For longer periods of time, 10 measurements should be enough. Measurements to be of output of experienced workers, but not necessarily the fastest, it is worth taking the effort of an average team into consideration. Measurements to be taken at the time where there are no interruptions or failures.